What I would like to do for the rest of the week is to walk you through a simple example, actually a very simple example, but that will involve all the steps that we will be investigating during the whole course. And the idea is that this simple example will help you to understand the various issues that are important when we develop a choice model. The objectives of this simple example is to introduce you to the basic components of choice modeling. We will start by defining the problem. We will talk about data, about model specification, parameter estimation, and model application. And the context where we will apply the simple example is an application where we would like to analyze the market for electric cars. Because we are interested in the market of electric cars, the choice that we are interested in is the choice of each individual to purchase an electric car or not. And the research questions that we have is, what is the current market penetration for electric cars? But also, what will be the future market penetration for electric cars? How will this market evolve in the future? And we will see how to address these research questions in the context of these choice problems by going through all the steps of model development. The first thing that we need to do is to observe actual behavior and to collect data. Before we do that, we need to identify the population of interest. It has to be clearly identified. In our simple example, we define the population of interest as all adults who are age 20 and above, who are living in Switzerland, and who own a car. Now, this population is big. There are many people who correspond to this definition. Therefore, we cannot interview all of them, and we identify a sample of 2,500 individuals. These individuals are randomly selected within the full population. In practice, these people, these individuals who are in the sample, receive a questionnaire or they are interviewed by somebody and have to respond to many questions. In the context of this simple example, we will keep the list of questions very short. We will ask them two questions. The first question is your car electric? Remember, the population is defined as all the owners of a car, so everybody owns a car. So the question is your car electric, yes or no? And the second question is about the age. What is your age range? And we define three ranges: 20 to 39, 40 to 64, and 65 and above. Again, these questions are designed to keep the example simple. After we have collected the data, we have for each individual in the sample the response to each of the two questions. So we know if the car is electric or not, and we know if the age is in one of the three categories that we have defined. So in this simple example, we can actually organize all these responses into this table that we call a contingency table. This table has two rows corresponding to the two possible answers to the first question, and it has three columns corresponding to the three possible answers of the second question. It means that each single individual in the sample is associated to exactly one cell of this table, depending on the answer he gave to these questions. So therefore, we can count how many individuals correspond to each combination of responses. So for instance, there are five individuals who responded that they own an electric car and they have an age which is 65 or above. So this contingency table contains all the information we have collected from the data. Now we can make some analysis about this table. For example, we can calculate how many people in the sample belongs to each of the age group. We have 900 people belonging to the age group 20 to 39, 1,100 people belonging to the age group 40-64, and 500 people belonging to the age group 65 and above. We can also calculate the row totals. So if we calculate the number of people who responded that they own an electric car, we obtain 125. And if we calculate the total number of people who responded that they do not own an electric car, we obtain 2,300. 375. And of course, if you make the sum of these two numbers, you obtain 2,500, which is the total number of people in the sample. And obviously, you will obtain the same total if you sum these three columns totals here. So this is very interesting because we can actually respond to the first research question looking at this table. The first research question was, what is the current market penetration in the population? Well, we can immediately see what is the market penetration in the sample. We have 125 people who responded that they own an electric car among a total of 2,500. So we have a total of 5% of the people who responded that they have an electric car. So this is the market share in the sample. And now what we will do is to use statistical inference. Because we have selected the people completely randomly in the population, we will infer that this percentage that we observed in the sample is the same in the population. So using this contingency table and statistical inference, we give the answer to the first research question that 5% is the market penetration of electric cars now, currently. Good. But now how do we predict? The second research question is, how will this market penetration evolve in the future? Well, in order to predict, we need a model. We cannot use data only. We need a model. And this is what we will do next.